Power tool became a sub. Oh yay, 3 years. Tool became a sub. Oh yay, 3 years.
when I'm ready and not before. I'm ready and not before.
Sure. the birds to sacrifice one of their kind for the feast. He gave these offerings to Arohomui, who cooked them in a great fire stone pit. Seeing all of those plump birds cooking made Kitava very hungry, and he offered to watch them, to make sure they didn't burn while Arohomui rested during the heat of the day. Arohomui thanked Kitava for his kindness, but while she slept, Kitava ate the cooking birds, flesh, bones, gizzards and all. Upon waking, Arohomui was furious to find that Kitava had lied to her, for saying that he would watch the birds when he truly intended to eat them all up. When Tukohama arrived home in his mighty canoe, Arohomui asked him to punish Kitava for his selfish gluttony. Tukohama, our father of war, agreed and pulled the sharpest tooth from his own mouth. He then asked Arohomui and Tafor to hold Kitava fast while he cut Kitava's face with the tooth. Two slashes that blinded Kitava and formed a bleeding cross upon his face. From that day forth, Kitava would never be able to promise to watch that which he truly intended to consume.
Thank you.
I'm ready, and not before.
Tsukuhama, our father of war, and Valakor, father of storm. To Kitava to Kinekora, mother of deer. They asked her to kill the greedy Kitava. For surely their tribe would starve if Kitava continued to live among them. But Hinekora refused, for death would not teach Kitava the lesson he needed to learn. Instead, Hinekora beat Kitava with a whip woven of her own hair. To Kitava, each strand was a searing lash. And so he wore thousands and thousands of blistering lashes across his back as Hinekora drove him relentlessly into the darkest corner of the underworld. There she left him to suffer, without water or food, for the rest of eternity. And there Kitava remained, in the darkness of Hinekora's night-clad island, for time beyond measure. There he suffered, waiting for the day that he could return to the world of light, to slake his scorching thirst and satiate his ravening hunger.
Too much clutter.
Thank you.
Too much clutter. Much clutter.
To replace the feast of birds that Kitava had greedily consumed, Zukohama, our father of war, and Valako, father of storm, went fishing. Although Kitava was blind, he could still cast his line and feel when a fish took his bait. So, Zukohama and Valako took him with them on Zukohama's mighty canoe. But while they fished, Kitava grew hungry and secretly ate all of their bait of grubs and worms. Disgusted and angry, Zukohama and Valako decided to use Kitava as bait instead. Valako used his own jawbone as a hook, impaled Kitava on it, and cast both into the sea. Kitava sank to the bottom of the sea, but instead of the fish eating Kitava, it was Kitava who ate all of the fish that nibbled at him, flesh, scales, guts, and all. When Zukohama and Valako hauled a fat-bellied Kitava back up from the sea, they were even more furious and knew that Kitava must be punished one final time.
Not all slaves believe Dutula's lies. Some I know have managed to steal a ship and are soon to set sail for Namakanui. Hopefully, with these treasures on board, Valakor will bless their voyage and breathe deeply into their sails. No, I'm not going with them. I helped bring this curse down upon Oriath, so I'll help save what little there is left to save. Here, take something. In thanks for your part in preserving the Karui Way.
ready and not before.
One person's beginning is another person's end. I wonder what your end is.
Much clatter. Too much clatter. That would just make life complicated. When I'm ready, and not before.
Do I hear the clink of markers in your pockets? Claimed from one of your victims. Or perhaps the victim of one of your victims. It is impossible to know how far back that chain could unwind, but now they belong to you. And you seem to be in good health. To the victor, etc. It seems you are the one I have patiently waited for. Yes, you will do just fine. Take a marker in your hand, speak these words into your mind. The ring binds us all, and to all within I shall do no harm. I will see you soon. Stay out of trouble.
Greetings. The beast was never a cruel master. It didn't want to destroy, to corrupt, to terrorize. It simply existed to exist. I made it that way. Unfortunately, in neglecting to provide it with ambition, I made it vulnerable to the ambitions of others. Queen Atziri and Doriani, Emperor Chittis and Malakai, others even before them. I created a beast that would free humanity from the tyranny of the gods. Yet all I really did was provide the perfect tool with which humanity could tyrannize itself. Farewell.
A wretched sight. So many drowned Oriathans cast into undeath. You freed them from their torment, and I'm sure they'd be grateful. Here, that little something extra I were talking about. Though the sea takes away, it gives back in greater measure. While you be skulking about, I've managed to do a bit of hunting on my own. Got a hole full of baubles and trinkets here, which I managed to, procure. Take a look. You might find something particularly naughty to help you on your life's voyage.
Time and tide wait for no man.
Good tidings to you.
Mm-hmm. Time and tide wait for no man.
Look at the sheen on that plum. Is it not the most delectable fruit that you've ever seen? No? Perhaps the gloss of hope is for my eyes only. Wondrous! Nothing bonds two souls more soundly than murder. For that reason alone, I knew you could be relied upon. Now, for a little amateur vintnering. A quick squeeze of the plum like so into the decanter. Oh my! Look how it transmutes the juice so swiftly from material to spectral. Effortless. And what an aroma. Imminent death. Never smelled so sweet. I believe I shall call this fine concoction the Imperial Nightcap. Now, before I get too carried away, there's the small matter of your recompense. A toast to swift endings and promising new beginnings. Oh, and you might want to avert your gaze once I have quaffed this diabolical brew. I doubt that my return to solidarity will be a pretty one. Right. As I used to say in the love dens of Trafus, bottoms up, girls! Oh, my. Now, that's an unusual sensation. Oh, dear. Something is amiss. The Allflame. It's... No. No, no, no. It's gone out. What am I... What are you? No. You cannot be. I will not...
Sailor boy, doomed to go wherever the winds blow him.
Thank you.
not be hidden.
Thank you.
Too much clutter. Ready, and not before.
Thank you. It's a